Hi everyone, welcome to Yoga with Tia. I hope everyone's having a wonderful day. And so today's Vinyasa is going to be Vinyasa for surfers. But if you're not a surfer, it doesn't matter. You can totally join me because we're going to be focusing on the range of motions in the hips and in your shoulders. We're going to also be strengthening those legs and cores and arms. So I think it's quite good that you also join if you're not a surfer. So whenever you're ready, you just come, follow me, and we're going to start in a child pose. So from here, we're going to come into our knees, and then just release the glutes towards your hips, and then bring the forehead down towards the mat, and stay here, relaxing the forehead towards the mat. Just breathe in deeply and breathe out fully. Being aware of your breath. Aware how the air comes in and out through your nose. Expanding towards your belly and your whole body. Just breathing deeply to your chest and let it go down to your belly. And then just breathe out all your worries, all your doubts, whatever it is that is wandering around your mind right now, just drop it down towards the earth. Just stay there in a child pose. Allowing soft and gentle breaths to come into your body. And then breathe out and release. Just relaxing your shoulders, relaxing your neck. And then our next inhalation, I want you to breathe in deeply and start rounding your spine into a cat, looking towards your belly button. Slowly dropping the hips down and opening your chest up towards the ceiling into a cobra. Exhale, bring your hips up and coming into a child pose, letting your hips guide the movement. Again, inhale, round your spine into a cat, dropping your hips down, opening your chest up towards the ceiling. Exhale, hips up into a child pose. Inhale, round your spine, slowly hips down, open your chest into a cobra. Exhale into a child pose. Keep doing this movement with your own rhythm. Allowing the breath to guide the movement. Exhale, come back into a child pose. Two more breaths like this. Inhale, round the spine as much as you can. And slowly open your chest and look up. Exhale, come back into a child pose. One more time. Just observe your spine. And exhale, come back to a child pose. Stay here for two breaths. Grounding the forehead to the mat, connecting your third eye towards the earth, your intuition, next inhalation, we're going to come into all fours. Make sure that your wrists are aligned with your shoulders and your knees hip width apart. From here, we're going to inhale, bring your right arm up towards the ceiling, look up to your hand. Exhale, pass your right arm through your left arm, bringing the shoulder down, looking up. Inhale again, bring your right arm up, look up. Exhale, down, bringing the shoulder down, bending into that left elbow. Inhale up, one more time. Exhale down. I want you to stay here for 5 breaths. Relaxing the shoulder down, your head down. You can bring your left arm forward. If you want to go deeper, bring your left hand through the back and wrap to your right leg. 5 breaths here. We're in the second breath. Relax down. Allow your shoulder and your head melt towards the earth. Last breath. Slowly bring that left hand towards the mat. Push with your hand and come back into all fours. Adjust the tabletop position again. Align your body. And now inhale, we're going to bring your left arm up, look up, open your chest. Exhale, pass it through your right arm, bringing your left shoulder down, your ear down. Inhale, left arm up, look up. Exhale, down, pass it through your right arm. One more time, inhale, left arm up. Exhale, go down, and we're going to stay here 5 breaths, bringing your left elbow down, head down, right arm in front, or all the way to the back, wrapping your left leg. Wherever you are, just relax your shoulders, relax your neck, there's no tension here. We're in the third breath. 4 and 5. Inhale and bring that right hand towards the mat. Push with your hand and bring your body up into a tabletop position again. Here I want you to bring your hands forward towards the mat. We're going to go to extended puppy pose. So we're going to inhale here, look up, exhale and bring your chest down towards the mat. Bring the forehead down to the mat. The hips are looking up towards the ceiling. If you want to go deeper, bring the chin all the way down, melting the heart down towards the earth. We're going to stay here, breathing deeply and breathe up fully to the back of your heart. Just observe that every time you inhale, how the heart expands. And I want you to bring gratitude to your heart right now. What are you grateful for? One more time. Slowly from here, ground your hands down to the mat. Inhale, round your spine, look towards your belly button, and slowly bring your hips down towards the mat. Bring your whole body down to the mat. Bring that forehead down, and then bring the hands next to your chest. Tuck your elbows in towards the body. And from here, we're going to inhale and come into a baby cobra. Roll your shoulders back and down. Bring your feet together. Belly button towards your spine, strong back. From here, try and bring the hands out of the mat, bringing the arms to the back, and from here, inhaling and trying to bring your chest a little bit more forward, pointing feet and legs up if you want. If this is too much, keep your legs down towards the mat. Stay here, and we're going to inhale, bring the arms forward. Exhale to the back into a cactus, opening a bit more. Inhale to the front. Exhale. Inhale to the front. Exhale to the back. Inhale to the front. Exhale to the back. One more time. Inhale to the front. Exhale to the back. Stay here. Open your chest. Feet together, pointing feet. Your whole back is engaged. Belly button towards your spine. Exhale and relax down. Now from here, we're going to bring the arms to the back. Interlace your fingers. And again, we're going to inhale, roll your shoulders back and down and bring your chest up. Look forward. You can stay here or bring your legs up also, pointing feet together. 5 breaths here. Every time you inhale, try to go a little bit more up. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Exhale, allow your whole body to go down towards the mat. Relaxing, 2 breaths here. 1, observing your heartbeat, and 2, bring the hands next to your chest. I want you to tuck your toes in, belly button towards your spine. So if you pass your hand through your belly, you can pass it. If it's not engaged, it's not possible. So from here, hands next to your chest, look forward. From here, inhale, push with your hands and bring your body up, your torso up. Stay here, exhale here. Inhale and bring your knees up into a plank. You can stay here. If this is too much, bring your knees down. If you're in a plank, make sure your elbows is aligned with your wrists and your belly is not falling down. You're engaging us. Look forward. Exhale and bring your hips up in downward facing dog. Look down to your toes, relax your head. Inhale, look up to your hands, and we're going to walk slowly towards your hands. When you arrive, lengthen the spine to the middle up. Exhale, fold forward, open your feet hip width apart. Bend your knees and allow your whole head to hang loose here. You can keep the hands in the mat, but without any strength. You can grab your elbows or you can hug your knees. Whatever feels more comfortable for you right now, but just let that head go down towards the mat, relaxing those shoulders, lengthening the spine. This is so wonderful. Slowly, we're going to bring the hands down to the mat. And we're going to inhale and go up slowly, vertebra by vertebra, keeping those knees bent. Slowly, with your inhalation, the last thing that comes up is your head. Exhale here when you arrive all the way up. So now we're going to come to Samasthiti. So I want you to bring your toes together, hips slightly apart, belly button towards your spine, roll your shoulders back and down. We're going to go to Sun Salutation A. So we're going to inhale, bring the arms up, look up. Exhale, fold forward, bend your knees if you don't reach down. Inhale, chest up, look up. Exhale, step or jump back, chaturanga, controlling the weight down, elbows in. You can do it with your knees if you want. Inhale, push with your hands, open your chest into a cobra or upward facing dog. Inhale, tap your toes and bring your hips up in downward facing dog. Stay here. I want you to open your hands, and with your hands you push the floor away. So you bring your hips up and then to the back, trying to ground those heels down towards the mat. But if your hips don't touch the ground, it doesn't matter. Relaxing your head down, looking to your toes. If there's any tension in the hamstring, bend your knees and bring the torso towards your thighs. Relaxing your head down. Inhale and look up to your hands. Walk or jump in between your hands and lengthen the spine to the middle up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale and come up, bringing the arms up and looking up towards your hands. Exhale, samasthiti. One more time. Inhale, bring the arms up, look up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, chest up, look up. Exhale, step or jump back, chaturanga, controlling the weight down, elbows in. Inhale, cobra, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog, look to your toes, stay here. Make sure that your shoulders are not going towards your ears. You push the shoulders away from your ears. Breathe in deeply and breathe out fully, trying to have the same length in your inhalation and your exhalation. Now from here, we're going to inhale and bring that right leg up towards the ceiling into a three-leg dog. Exhale, bring the right foot in between your hands, bringing that left knee down towards the mat. Inhale, bring the torso up. Exhale, sink those hips down towards the mat. Now inhale, bring the arms up. Exhale, open your chest. Bring the hands down towards the mat if you are right. If not, stay here. Try to push those hips down and opening the whole front of your body. Stay there for 3 breaths. Just trust yourself. Just keep breathing, opening the chest. One more breath. Inhale, come back to the center. Exhale, extend that front knee. Inhale here, length up. Exhale and fall forward. Bring the hands next to your leg. Inhale here, look up. Exhale and fold forward, look up to your toe. If you don't reach down, you can always grab blocks and use the blocks to fall forward. 2 more breaths here, relax your shoulders, look up. You want to bring the nose towards your toe. Inhale and belly to that knee, look up. And exhale, come back into downward facing dog. Inhale, bring that left leg up towards the ceiling, 3-legged dog. Exhale, left foot in between your hands. Bend that right knee, bring that right knee down towards the mat. Inhale, come up. Exhale, sink those hips down towards the mat. Inhale, bring the arms up. Exhale and start folding towards the back with the torso, opening your chest, looking towards the ceiling, or if you can, try and look what's in your back. Try and with your hands touch the ground. 3 more breaths here, try to bend into that left knee. Inhale, come back to the center.
Exhale, extend that left knee. Inhale, length up. And exhale, bring the hands down to the mat. Inhale, look up. And exhale, fall forward to your side. Look up to your toe. You want to kiss your toe with your mouth, with your lips. Sorry. Stay there. Breathing deeply, observing the stretch in the back of your leg. Two more breaths here. Inhale and bend into that left knee. Look up. Exhale and come back to downward facing dog. Bring the left leg to the back and bringing the hips up towards the ceiling. Relax your head down. Inhale, bring that right leg up towards the ceiling again. Exhale, right foot in between your hands. We're going to come into a higher lunge, bending to that right knee. Inhale, come into a higher lunge. Make sure that your knees align with your ankle and your left heel is up towards the ceiling. Stay in tune and cactus arms here. Look forward. Stay there. Right hip to the back, left hip to the forward. Look into the short edge of the mat. Open here. Two more breaths here. Feeling the strength of that right leg. And now slowly inhale, bring the arms and extend your right leg up. Exhale down. Inhale, bring the energy up. Exhale down. Inhale up. And exhale, bend into that right knee, rotate to the right and extend the arms to the side. Look into that right hand, but you're lengthening the spine up towards the ceiling, trying to bend a bit deeper into that right knee. Slowly, right hand. We're going to bring it to the left leg. Inhale, open your left side of your body into a reverse. Trying to go deeper into that right knee. Exhale, left elbow to your right knee. Pravritta Parsvokanasana. Hands in a prayer. Left elbow, right knee. If this is too much, left knee down. Push with your hands. And try to twist towards the right, looking to the ceiling up. Make sure you're not falling to your leg. Remember, there's a space in between your thigh and your belly. Stay here, two more breaths. Every time you exhale, try to rotate a little bit more. If your left knee is up, try to push that left leg forward. If your left knee is down, inhale, bring your left leg up. Slowly bring your left heel down towards the mat so your hips are opening to the left side. Then bring your left arm around towards the left, slowly following with your body. Inhale, bring your whole body up. And exhale, bend into that right knee. Warrior two. I'm sure you did it right. It's a really weird movement, but it's beautiful. Bending into that right knee, aligning the knee with your ankle. Hips look into the long edge of the mat. Relax your shoulders. Look to your right arm. Inhale, reverse your warrior. We're going to go to the back. Left hand to your right thigh or left hand to your left leg. Open, look up to your hand. Make sure you're bending into the right knee. Exhale, right elbow to your right thigh. Parsvokanasana. Left arm towards the front. Look up to your hand. Push with your elbows to open your chest. Look up to your hand. If you know the other variation to go all the way down towards the mat, stay here. But if you're collapsing down,
go up to your knee. Keep the weight also to the edge of the left foot, to the outer edge. One more breath here. Feel it in that right leg and right hip. Inhale, slowly extend that right knee, bringing the arms up. Exhale, rotating your left foot to the short edge of the mat and bending into that left knee. Slowly, with control, bringing your body down. Bringing that parts of the hand together next to your chest. If you cannot go all the way down and you're here, it's okay, stay here. If you're down, you can stay here, extend the arms. Or if you can, try to make the bind in the back. Use whichever variation you are right now. Don't try to push your body. Two more breaths here, opening the chest, bringing the breath all the way down to the whole body to bring all the benefit of the breath. Our next inhalation with control, again, we're going to go up, bringing that right arm up. Exhale, bending into that right knee and going into Parsvottanasana, right elbow to your right thigh. Left hand towards the front, if you want, go all the way down to the floor. So we're going to do this movement in a flow 3 times. So we're going to inhale, extend that right leg, slowly bending into that left knee. Going all the way down. If you're here, stay here. If not, go all the way down. Inhale, controlling the way up. Bending into that right knee, Parsvottanasana. Two more. Inhale, up. Exhale, bending into that left knee. Inhale, up. You can do it with or without your hands in the floor. One more time. Inhale up. Exhale, bending to the left knee. And inhale, going all the way up. And now bending into that right knee, bringing your two hands down to the mat, squaring the hips to the short edge of the mat. Stay here. Align your knee with your ankle. Inhale, bring the arms to the back, open your chest, stay here. So you're not bringing the torso up, you're leaning the belly to your thigh, but your chest is up. 5 breaths here. Three. Four. And 5, exhale, bring that left knee down, relax your right leg, there you go. Now slowly, we're going to bring the hands down to the mat, and we're going to bring that right foot to the right side of the mat, just walk that foot to the right edge of the mat, so you create space to your hips to go down, bring the hands aligned with your foot. We're going to inhale here, lengthen your spine. Exhale, try to go as down as possible. You can stay with your hands. You can try and go all the way down to your elbows. Stay here. And last variation to go deeper, bring your left knee up. If you bring the elbows down, look forward, dragon. Just stay in this pose, wherever you are, just try to be conscious and try to visualize that every time you inhale, you bring the breath all the way down to those hips. And when you exhale, you're releasing any tightness, any tension that you're feeling right now. Just breathe it out and let it go. It could be emotions that we're holding. It could be some trauma that we had when we were kids, or something that happened in the past and we're just holding it there. So whatever it is, I want you to just let it go. Breathe out. could be also any worries from these days. There's a lot going on these days, so I just want you to observe your body. Breathe out, let go. Relax and your head down. 5 more breaths here. Here, just one more breath. Inhale deeply. Exhale fully. And slowly we're going to bring the hands and bring your torso up. Exhale here, tuck your left toes in. Inhale, push with your hands and bring that leg to the back into downward facing dog. Relax your head down. Look to your toes. And then we're going to inhale and bring that right leg again up towards the ceiling. Bend into that right knee and bring your right foot to your left hip. Open your right hip. Inhale, square your hips, bring that right leg up. Exhale slowly your right leg, your whole right leg towards the front into a pigeon. Going all the way down. Just relaxing your hips down here. Trying to square the hips to the short edge of the mat. Hips are going to the right side. You cannot square the hips. Just grab a block, wrap a blanket, pillow or book and place it to your right gluteus so your hips can be squared. Here we're going to inhale, sink the hips down. Exhale, slowly walk down as far as you can go. Wherever you are, come in your elbows, come in your hands. Just relax the head down. And stay there, pushing that left hip down and the right hip to the back. We're going to stay there for some breaths. Just breathing deeply. Breathe up fully, it's another hip opener. We're always putting so much into our hips that we just don't feel. We don't allow ourselves to feel whatever it is in our minds. So I invite you right now to try to observe what's in your mind without judging. Knowing that whatever it is, it doesn't define you, it's not who you are. So just breathe it out. Any fear, any anger that you're holding right now, just let it go. Two more breaths here. Inhale and slowly bring your hands towards you, bringing the torso up. So now we're going to twist this pigeon. So we're going to inhale, length up. Exhale, start twisting towards the left side of your body, as far as you can go. Maybe you stay here, it's okay, look to the back, stay here. You want to go deeper, bring that right knee down, palms of the hand together, trying to bring it to the middle of your chest, push with your hand to make a bit more of a twist and look to the back. And if you even want to go deeper, bring the elbow towards your right foot, pushing with your hands and twisting a little bit more. But don't try to push your body right now. Try to be gentle. Just see what is best for you today. Just listening to your body, breathing deeply, breathe out fully. Stay here. here for 3 more breaths. Exhale, slowly come back to the center. Tap your left toes. Inhale, bring that right knee up towards your chest and slowly right leg up towards the ceiling. Exhale, right foot towards the mat into downward facing dog. And here I want you to observe the difference in between your right leg and your left leg. How does it feel? Does it feel longer? Does it feel heavier? Just observe without judging. Slowly we're going to inhale and bring that left leg up towards the ceiling. Exhale, bring that left foot in between your hands. We're going to come to a higher lunge, bending into that left knee. Slowly coming up into a cactus arm. Stay here. Belly button towards your spine. Activate that right leg up towards the ceiling. Bending into that left knee. Stay here. Just using that every time you inhale, you try to bring the energy up towards the sky. One more breath. And we're going to inhale, extend your whole body up. Exhale, go down and let go. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. And inhale up, stay here. Exhale, bend into that left knee, twist to the left, and bring the arms to the side. Stay here, look to your left hand. Now bring your left hand to your right leg, to the back of your right leg, and bring your right hand up and to the back, making a little twist, reversing this pose, looking up to your hand, bending into that left knee. Exhale, slowly twist a bit more to the left, bringing that right elbow towards your left knee. Bring that right knee down. Parabrita Parsvakonasana. Hands in a prayer, push with your hands and try to look what's in your back. Make sure you're not leaning on your thigh, in your thigh. You can stay here or bring that right knee up. Either right knee up, just try to push your body a little bit more forward. So you're not collapsing to the back, you're pushing towards the front. Two more breaths here. If your right knee is down, inhale, bring your right leg up. Exhale, rotate your right toe, your right foot, and bring the hip down towards the mat. So automatically your hip opens to the right side of the mat, bringing the right arm around, opening up towards the ceiling. Exhale, bend it into that left knee, into warrior two. Stay here, bend it into that left knee. Make sure that the knee doesn't go to the inside, you're pushing it away, relaxing those shoulders and just feeling that burning sensation in your legs. It's okay, just say to yourself, I am strong enough, I can do this. That's the attitude, relax your shoulders, crown of the head up towards the ceiling. Inhale, reverse your warrior, open, look up, bend into that left knee. Exhale, bring your left elbow to your left thigh, crouch for Konasana. Look up to your hand, stay here, go all the way down, making sure you're making one line from your right foot all the way up to your right hand. If you're collapsing down, make sure you're going up to your thigh. Inhale, slowly come up, extend that left knee, start rotating your right foot and slowly bending into that right knee. Going all the way down, palms of the hand together, look up. If you cannot go all the way down, stay up here, it's okay. If you're down, choose your variation. Here, opening, or binding in the back, opening and looking up. Just feel the stretch in this leg, that wonderful stretch, opening your whole side of the leg. One more breath here. Opening the chest, bringing gratitude to your body. Slowly exhale, look down. Inhale with the strength of your legs, bring your whole body up. Exhale, Parsvakonasana. Again, we're going to do this 3 times, flowing with your breath. Make sure that you breathe before starting a movement. And we're going to inhale, extend that left leg. Exhale, bend it into that right knee, going all the way down. I almost fall. Inhale, come all the way up. Exhale, Parsvakonasana. You can go all the way to the floor if you want. Inhale, extend that left knee. Exhale, bend into that right knee. Open up. If you can, you can always help with your hands. Inhale, coming up. Exhale, bending into Parsvakonasana. Last time. Inhale to the back, extend up. Exhale, go down, look up. Inhale, come up. And now exhale, bring your whole 2 hands down to the mat, bending into that left knee and bringing that right knee down towards the mat. Now we're going to go to the dragon. Bring that left foot to the left side of the mat. Hands align with your foot. We're going to inhale here, length. Exhale, hips down. Try to go all the way down. Just bring your hips down. I'm going to change again off the side. You stay with your left leg. Just grounding your hips down. Allowing your head to fall down. Just remember, no matter where you are, if you're with your hands, relax your head down. If you're in your elbows, also relax your head down. And if you want to go deeper, right knee up. Just stay here. Breathing deeply and trying to visualize that breath coming tall all the way from your nose down to your hips. And then just breathe out and release any tension. Release whatever doesn't serve you right now. Allowing those hips to go down every exhalation. Allowing yourself to surrender down towards the earth. Being grateful to be here right now. Inhale. can slowly push with your hands. Bring the torso up. Tuck your right toes. Inhale and bring that left leg to the back into downward facing dog. Relaxing your head down, pushing with your hands your body away. And now again, inhale and bring that left leg up towards the ceiling. Bending into that left knee, opening the left hip, bringing the left foot to your right hip. Trying to twist, opening the chest up towards the ceiling. There you go, beautiful stretch. Inhale and rotate your hip square into the mat. Extend that left leg. Exhale and bring your left leg all the way down towards the front of the mat into a pigeon. Again, just square the hips to the short edge of the mat. From here, remember, if you're falling down, wrap a block, wrap a pillow, and bring it towards your left glute so your hips are squared to the short edge of the mat. From here, we're going to inhale. Exhale and fall forward. Just melt your heart down towards the leg, allowing your forehead to fall down towards the mat. If this is too much for you, you can always keep the hands here and let the head hang heavy here. Pushing that right hip down. Just wherever you are, relax your head, relax your shoulders. Stay here, observing your left hip. Breathing deeply and breathe out fully any tension, any tightness that you're holding in this part of your body. Allowing yourself to let go and to not control absolutely anything right now. Just to feel and be with your body. That's the best gift that you can give to yourself. Every time you inhale, try to go a little bit more deeper with your breath. Try to bring that breath all the way down to your hips. Even trying to bring it towards your legs and to your feet. Slowly after your next exhalation, we're going to inhale and bring the torso up. There you go. Wiggle a bit your hips. We're going to inhale here, lengthen your spine. Exhale, start rotating your body to the right side of the mat. We're going to go to the twist pigeon. You can stay here, look into the back. If you want to go even a bit more deeper, bring your left elbow down. Bring the hands in a prayer. Push with your hands and try to bring the hands in the middle of your chest. And look and twist a bit more towards the right. If you want to even go more deeper, if you have more advanced practice, bring the elbow towards your left foot. And then you push there and try to make a bit more of a twist. Make sure you're bringing that right hip down towards the ground. Opening your chest, looking to the back. Choose whichever variation you want. Make sure you're making that twist deeper every time you exhale. Two more breaths here. And slowly exhale, come back to the front. Inhale, tuck those toes in. Exhale here. Inhale, left leg up towards your chest and then up towards the three-leg dog. Exhale, left foot down into downward facing dog. Relax your head. And slowly we're going to do a vinyasa. Inhale here, exhale here. Inhale, round your spine and coming into a plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, downward facing dog. Exhale, open your knees and come down into a child pose. Bringing the forehead to the mat, melting your heart down towards the earth. Stay here for a couple of breaths. Coming back to your breath. Just observing the breath coming in and out from your nose. Observing your heartbeat. Inhale slowly, bring the torso up. And then shift the weight towards one side and extend the legs in front of you. So now here, I want you to bring that right foot next to your left leg. Bring that left leg away. Your hips are squared to the short edge of that, to the long edge of the mat. Here we're going to inhale, bring the arms up. Exhale, bring that left hand to your right thigh. Inhale, extend your right arm up. Exhale and let your body fall to the left, but without collapsing here, we're opening, grounding that right hip down. Just letting that hand try to go towards your left foot. Observing the stretch of the right side of your body. Two more breaths here. If your arm keeps is tired, you can just let it hang here. Inhale and come up. Exhale and bring the arms down. Now change of side. Make sure you're grounding into that left hip and grounding that right leg down towards the mat. So we're going to inhale, bring the arms up. Exhale, right hand to your left thigh. Inhale, left arm up. Exhale, twist, like fold towards the right. With your left hand, try to go to your right foot without collapsing down. The importance here is to open the whole chest. Open up, look up. Don't collapse neither with your shoulder. Make sure there's space between your shoulder and your ear. If your arm gets tired, just bring the hand to the back of your head. Stay here. And just breathing deeply, trying to make more space to the left side of your body. Two more breaths. Inhale and come up. And exhale, bring the arms down. And we're going to go into a butterfly. So you bring the soles of the feet together. Relax your knees. Lengthen the spine to the middle up. Here, grab your toes and we're going to inhale here. Exhale and fall forward, bringing the chest down to your feet. Here, wherever you are, relax your head down. You can bring the arms to the front and just let your head hang heavy. Just doesn't matter where you are. If you cannot bring the elbows and you're with your hands, relax just the head down. Releasing any tension from your shoulders and your neck. And just focusing in your hips. Just breathing deeply and breathe. Bring the breath all the way down to your hips. Breathe out and allow any tightness, any darkness to release up from your hips. Just allowing any emotion to come up right now. Any old emotion that you're holding back in your body. I want you to just observe and see how your body feels without judging, without trying to change anything. And when you breathe out, I want you to release that emotion that you're holding back into your body and it's making you suffer. Just breathe out and allow that fear to release. Allowing yourself to feel joy and happiness. Two more deep breaths in. One more time. Slowly from here, walk the hands towards you and bring your torso up vertebra by vertebra. Close your eyes and bring the hands. Bring your right hand to your heart and your left hand in top of your right hand. Allowing the warmth of your hands touch your heart. And just connecting with your heart here. Smiling directly to your heart, being grateful to be here right now. Just observe and listen that heartbeat. And then say to yourself, I love you. And say your name. Breathing deeply. I love you, Lucia. And every time you exhale, believe what you're saying. Say yes. You can say out loud or say to yourself. Breathing deeply. I love you, Lucia. Just breathe out that affirmation. Yes, I do. Just observing the connection of your heart with your body. One more time. Then slowly bring the palms of the hand together in Anjali Mudra next to your heart, your thumbs touching your heart. And here I want you to think about something you're grateful of. And just repeat it to your heart 3 times. And slowly, I want you to bow your head down to your hands. Thankful for this practice. Thank you for coming to the mat and giving time to yourself. Namaste. Thank you everyone for joining. I hope you enjoyed this practice. If you want, you can go to Shavasana now and I invite you to stay 10 minutes. If not, have a wonderful day and see you in the next class.